Mets fans, the time is finally here. We're finally going to see our boys play game one of 162 tonight versus the hated Philadelphia Phillies. I believe it's destiny. On today's episode of Bearded Mets Banter, we're going to talk about today's game, and we're also going to talk about the debacle at Washington. I feel they should be sanctioned. Also, I'm going to start a new segment called Don't Be This Guy. It's a segment dedicated to social media feeds that I've been combing through of multiple Met groups throughout different social media platforms. And I'm going to be putting up some of the craziest posts I see with regards to the Mets and some of the delusions that people have with the business aspect and the player aspect as well. Some people don't have a fair understanding of the game and what it takes to play this at a high level. I just want to show that. It has to be done because I'm tired of this. Yo, the 7 train is right there. Let's get ready to get on. Let's go, Mets.
This is a Mets Willits Point bound 7 local train. The next and last stop is Mets Willits Point.
Stand clear of the closing doors, please.
You guys for tuning in. It is your boy Chente Camacho Jr. and here we go with another episode of Bearded Mets Banter. Today, let's just get right into it. The excitement is here. The season's finally here. We're about to get started playing some baseball after the craziness that happened down in Washington when game one gets called and then all of a sudden we find out the entire series has been postponed until further notice, until they reschedule the games. I feel it's a very irresponsible move on the part of the Washington Nationals and their players. I also feel that their players and the franchise are likely to be sanctioned by the Major League Baseball commissioner. I mean, he's doing already crazy things with moving the game, the All-Star game out of Atlanta. So why not? Let's touch on this. This is a serious issue. And from what I understand as well, the first game between the Nationals and the Braves has also been postponed. So if this continues to impact the league and the way we play games at this moment, action should be taken against the Washington Nationals franchise for this craziness. Now, Mets fans, we have a lot to be pumped up about. I think it's destiny that the Mets were to open the season in Philadelphia, given the proximity between the Phillies and the Mets. And the heated rivalry has been since maybe it started rekindling in 2005, I want to say, when we were both on the cusp of becoming great teams. And we all know what happens afterwards. We don't want to get into that because that's old history, right? But the revival of that rivalry is coming to be tonight when we have our beast, our horse, Jacob DeGrom. He'll take the mound against the Philadelphia Phillies, who are, I think, 3-0 right now. Yeah, they swept the Braves. So, you know, they're feeling good. They're feeling themselves. So, I'm hoping my boys come in there, our boys rather, come in there and take care of business. We got to do what we got to do, right? Yeah, it's been some crazy things going on these last few weeks, especially given the negotiations between the Mets and Francisco Lindor. You know, things were handled poorly on the behalf of the media. You know, we have the media. The media contributes to these things. And, you know, I'm just going to put this post, which relates to just a few hours before Francisco Lindor actually signed. And it reads, Mets, Francisco Lindor have set themselves up for contract disaster. This is misleading in many ways. It tells the fans one thing when the reality is that the negotiations were going hard at that very moment. Because as we see, hours later, the deal was closed and it was brought out to the media and we heard all about it. So bad work on the post on that part. All they did was spread false information because, as I mentioned just a second ago, the deal was closed just hours later. And Mets fans were going in a crazy panic. They were just talking all this crazy nonsense about Lindor and Cohen, how he's going to be a new version of the Wilpons. Oh my God, I can't believe I said their name. I vow to never mention their name again. But it's the complete opposite of that because what did Cohen do? He closed the deal, as we know. And that just leads me into my Don't Be This Guy segment. Please, I'm not doing this to bully or harass people. I don't want people to take this that way. But I just see, I've been seeing this for years. This is not something that I've just noticed. This is something I've been seeing for years. And you know what? When the Wilpons own the team, fine and dandy. I could understand it. You know what I'm saying? I can feel the angst, and I can feel where some of you are coming from with some of these posts back then. But this is a new era. This is a new ownership, and the direction it's taking is the right direction. Okay, this is one of the first posts that I want to start with. Please, don't be this guy. It reads, I can't wait for all those who were begging for Cohen, which is misspelled, to overpay Lindor to be screaming in 5 years. Why the hell did we give Lindor so much money? Now we can't sign players A, B, and C. Well, you're wrong, okay? Because the way things are working out here, we already have what we need here for the long haul, okay? The team control players that we have are going to exceed 4 or 5 years. That contracts are going to shed. Guys are going to leave via free agency, things like that. But we're going to have we already have a nucleus of players. We signed Lindor. Now it's time to sign Conforto. We have Pete Alonso on the control for a few more years. We signed James McCann. We have him for a few more years. JD Davis is under control. We'll arbitrate with him in a couple years. McNeil's under control for a few years. Nimmo's up for a contract negotiation next year. I don't see that really going very far. Noah Syndergaard's going to get extended in the next year or so. We have the pieces in place here to win, and not just win now, but win in the long term. All right? This comment and this is unnecessary, because all this does is create hostility. It creates confusion. All right? Mets fans need to be a little bit more patient. This is going somewhere really special. Trust me. We're going to do good, good things. Then we have this guy right here. He puts Mets and Lindor contract almost official. Right? And then he asks, what's the over and under on the first injury? Yo, really? On the first injury? That's the energy we're trying to bring to this? That's how I'm going to leave it at. Yo, these posts right here, like this one right here, this does not need to be in our space, yo. I'm a firm believer in energy, and to be throwing that out there, that's kind of wicked, man. You need to check yourself on that one. That's crazy to me. Then we have this one right here. Check this one out. It goes, good signing by the Mets in reference to Taijuan Walker when he signed with the Mets. He goes, when big talker, average pitcher Stroman, I don't understand why he doesn't like Marcus Stroman. Marcus Stroman is one of the most cerebral pitchers. I gloat about Marcus Stroman because he has that confidence that it borders cockiness to some people. But no, the dude is super positive. You have to understand his energy. And he's a team player, just in case, you know, don't get it twisted. The guy has tremendous heart and tremendous talent behind his arm. The kid is good, and he's going to give us a good year. He's going to keep you, you know, I want you to keep this energy as the season progresses, because I predict Marcus Stroman is going to have a pretty big season, especially in a contract season. So then he goes, Walker can take his spot. And then I don't want to talk about the rest. This guy right here is notorious on these groups. And I'm going to give you another one from him. This one's even more special. This is the last one. I want to end it with this guy right here. He is special. He's a special case. He goes, if Noah focused on pitching and staying healthy as much as he does, as much as he talks crap on Twitter, he would be an all-star pitcher. That's what he meant to wrote. And then he continues. I didn't even bother clicking to read the rest of his BS, because if this dude knew anything, he'd know Noah Syndergaard is on rehab. Rehabbing his arm. He had Tommy John surgery. You know what I'm saying? That's probably part of his rehab process. You know, work the fingers, all that. The phalanges or whatever, the metacarpals, whatever. You know, he's in there. He could do that. It's part of his rehab. And by the way, he's taking ownership of Trevor Bauer. He's really made Trevor Bauer his son. He's put Trevor Bauer in his back pocket, and he's put him away for later to play. So that is ridiculous. Now, jumping into tonight's game. The Mets and what we have going on, y'all. The Mets, I haven't been this excited about this team since 2006. This is a team that is primed to perform, not just for this season, for years to come. Mets fans, the time to be excited is here. The season is upon us. We are going to do great things. This is Bearded Mets Banter. I'm going to be here. It's my first season doing this. I'm super excited. Bear with me. I got tons of giveaways. I have a lot of stuff to give away. I have this nice little, you know, a Shea Stadium frame. I have a 2005 Mets yearbook. I have an Oktoberfest Mets Stein. I have two of them, actually. Back there, I have some highball Mets glasses, beer mugs. Not beer mugs, I'm sorry. Highball glasses. I have quite a few giveaways. I have more stuff coming. A bunch of stuff. Stay tuned. Guys, thank y'all so, so much for tuning in. I appreciate you guys. But before I go, please do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. Go ahead and click on that little button down there, y'all. Do what that little doggy's doing. And hit the bell for notifications when I drop new material and new videos. These videos will come more frequently as the season progresses. Guys, bear with me. It's my first season. I'm as excited as you are. Let's go, Mets. This has been another episode of Bearded Mets Banter. And we out, y'all. Let's go.
This is a Mets Willits Point bound 7 local train. The next and last stop is Mets Willits Point.
Stand clear of the closing doors, please.